Well, from Wheel of Fortune to Family Feud, Australians love a game show. And in the 70s, there was no bigger game than Temptation. In this Studio 10 exclusive, Craig Bennett has reunited the hosts, the dynamic duo of Tony Barber and Barbie Rogers.
Long before Chris and Julia, and even before there was Greg and Debbie, the hottest twosome on TV was Tony Barber and Barbie Rogers. Together, they hosted Temptation and its primetime spin-off, The Great Temptation, for almost 6 years. And today, after decades apart, they're reuniting.
Well, this is a TV game show reunion of the century. How does that kind of work?
It's more of a temptation, I think.
Well, of course, but that was a TV game show. God, I hope it was a TV game show.
I hope so too.
But we're going back quite a way.
Yep. Well, you two were the most famous TV double act of the 70s, I reckon.
I think we were the new age people of the 70s.
You were the new Bob and Dolly Dye, weren't you?
Yes,
we were a bit of a fluke, really.
The nation had never seen anything quite like Tony and Barbie.
May I?
Yes.
Mate?
Yes, that... you can sit on it.
Thank you very much.
Just keep your hands off the model, though, won't you?
They were playful, they were cheeky, and Barbie's innocence was loved by viewers, but almost got her into serious strife.
I guess what
you're real.
Well, as
real.
You know, Craig, what you see is what you get with me. And I don't know, there's never been any airs and graces because I didn't even know how to do it in those days.
But Barbie, you caused such a stir on telly back then because you were the first person in this country on television to wear hot pants and knee-high boots.
All after Bob and Dolly died. Long dresses, the long hair, and hello, Bob, how are you? This comes in, have a go.
And you start telling jokes that you didn't even realise were risque. What was the one about the submarine?
I told her not to tell the one about the submarine. And I said, but she told me, and I had a bit of a giggle, as men do. That's it. And then I said, for God's sake, don't you dare go up there.
And then he asked me on camera, what have I been doing all weekend? And of course,
you were supposed to say, I'm not going to tell you the joke. That's what you should have said.
I said, what's long and black and whole semen? And I looked at the distraught look on his face and I said, a submarine. And next minute, the hook came out to drag me off set by the producer.
Stop tape.
Just remember who the star is. I don't know. What happened there?
But you were totally innocent about that joke, genuinely,
no
weren't you?
I had no idea.
She should have let me tell the joke. I would never
have told the joke. Yeah, that's right.
I would have had to go to confession.
The chemistry between the dynamic duo carried over off the air. In those days, they would film 5 episodes a day. And shocking rumours have it Tony and Barbie would outrageously let their hair down during their lunch break.
You had to get 3 done by lunchtime, 12:30-ish. And we had a block booking at the Epping Chinese restaurant.
Good memory for me.
And down we'd go, and we'd have, you know, number 3, number 14, number 7, and a couple of bottles of...
Well, I won't say who did, but, I was with
hock.
You.
Hock we used to drink in those days. And then we'd go back, and the last 2 shows of the day would be just fantastic.
Dynamite.
God, we were so...
Like a breeze.
Oh.
The golden glow of that hock was coming through, was it?
People used to say, oh, we love your show, especially towards the end of the week. It gets so...
bubbly.
One infamous moment in the show's history was when a contestant passed away while filming.
You know, we had a contestant.
Yeah.
And she came on the show. She did very well, answered a lot of questions, won a lot of prizes.
Yep.
Congratulations, let's call her Edna. You've won the game. And she slumped onto the desk.
And didn't get up.
Oh, this is a good reaction. This is real television, you know. But unfortunately, stop tape.
She was still there.
Gone. The family had asked, she loved the show so much, that could it be that her ashes were scattered in the Channel 7 Rose Garden?
Close to us.
But behind Barbie's beaming smile was heartbreak. She was in the throes of a bitter divorce when she discovered she'd been adopted. She went into an emotional tailspin and, ultimately, a breakdown.
I remember, Barbie, you told me when you had that breakdown.
Yeah.
How Tony protected you from that, because it could have been the end of your
career.
Well,
yeah, we were about to go on stage. Tony was on stage up in Queensland and I collapsed with a nervous breakdown, because at that time I just found out I was adopted and my marriage was on the rocks at that time. And I had to be protected because I would have lost the job with Grundy's if they'd known that, you know, I was so ill. Mm.
So that's showbiz.
Yeah.
And I'm going out there, when you're smiling.
And everything's
she's out the back.
Yeah.
But that was the great energy and respect you two had for one another.
Temptation ended in 1975. Then, 5 years later, Tony would return as quiz king of The Sale of the Century, which turned him into a game show superstar all over again.
You auditioned yourself, didn't you?
They were going to do it. They were calling for auditions for compos and so forth. And I rang up and said, I'd like to be in that. I'll audition. Anyway, they said, well, you don't need to audition with us. So I did my own audition tape. It was about the time of The Godfather, and Brando had been overlooked for that part. And he wanted it badly. He really wanted it. And they wouldn't even audition. So he did his own. He put the cotton all in his mouth.
So you copied it?
And well, it's a good idea.
You're inspired by Brando.
You didn't.
As you consider this new soul, you should really stop it.
Now that the pair have reunited, could a small screen return be on the cards?
Any chance you might return, maybe a game show or something? Would you love to work together again?
How's your health? How's your back?
I'm fine. I can stand up to it.
Oh, could you?
You know what? No, look, honestly.
We've been there, we've done it.
This is a time and a place for everything.
Yeah.
My place is down the road from here, actually. And my time.
And I'm just grateful to be upright and breathing.
Yeah, that's it.
What more could you ask for?
Keep smiling and bye for now.